What's up, my YouTube family? Sergeant Greybeard back with another Division 2 video. Today is Wednesday, June 9th, and as always, I hope this message finds you healthy and safe. In today's video, my friends, I'll be showing you all of the stuff that Cassie has for sale this week, and for those of you that may not know how to find the Gunrunner, I'll also show you at the end of the video how to find the Snitch, which is how you gain access to Cassie. Now, if you happen to be new to the channel, feel free to hit that subscribe button. We would love for you to be a part of our gaming family. And if you enjoyed this or found it helpful at all, take a quick second and hit that like button. It really does help us out. One thing I want to mention really quick is starting now, I'm going to do these Cassie Mendoza resets every Wednesday no matter what. I have no idea why I haven't done them in the past, but again, my friends, they start today, so let's just jump into it. We are starting off with the swap chain. This is actually on sale at the clan vendor this week as well. I think it's a better roll. Here you see it has 12.7% SMG damage, 14% crit hit chance, and 9% headshot damage. It also has the talent Perfect Unwavering. However, as I mentioned a moment ago, it's also on sale at the clan vendor, so see which one is a better roll before you buy it. Next, we have the Zero F's Body Armor, Badger Tough, and this happens to be a really must-have for any inventory. Moving on to the next item for sale, we have the Shield Splinterer, and that is an item you're only going to see if you've defeated all of the hunters from year one. So if you're new or just returning to the game and you don't see this for sale, that's the reason why. Now, there are a bunch of videos online showing you exactly how to do that. Unfortunately, I never made one. By the way, I'm definitely buying this thing, and it is a bit of a grind to get all of the ivory keys you need in order to get this weapon. However, it is definitely worth it. You see the talent on here, Perfect Optimist. It is an absolute monster. Below that, we have an Aces and Eights backpack with 10.4% weapon damage, 5.6% crit hit chance. Nice roll there. Under that, we have some True Patriot. Kind of a roll do we have? Pretty decent there as well. Not the best, but again, if you don't have this, definitely pick it up. And once again, for new and returning players, always check out those attributes. Some of these items you may want to buy twice, one to use and one to obviously strengthen your recalibration library. Next, we have some Hunter's Fury gloves. Pretty decent roll there. Then we have some Aces and Eights knee pads as well. Really nice roll here. You can max that thing out any way you want, my friends. Below that, we have an Eclipse Protocol holster. Pretty decent roll there. Wish that, you know, secondary attribute was a little bit higher. Next, we have a Striker's Mask. Good roll. I wish that secondary one was, you know, crit hit chance or crit hit damage, but again, it happens to be a good piece of gear. Continuing on, my friends, we have the MP7 submachine gun. Pretty decent roll there. Has a talent Optimist. It is one of my favorite talents in the game, so you may want to check that thing out. Moving on, we have a marksman rifle. Again, really good roll here. Things seem to be just, on an average, pretty decent this week. Below that, we have a China Light backpack. Let's see what type of a roll it is. Not that great. I'd pass on this one if you don't already have it. Or again, in your recalibration library, you want to make sure you have that talent as well. Let's see what kind of an Overlord mask we have below that. And it is a definitely must buy this week. Once you recalibrate that bottom attribute to anything you want, you can then optimize the top one, which is weapon damage, so you can have a fully god-rolled piece of gear. So again, anytime you see these in the game and you do not have them, definitely pick up one, if not two. Finally, my friends, we finish off with some mods and skill attachments. We have something for skill haste, pretty decent. Something for your pulse radius, pretty decent as well. But I would say, honestly, like, this was a really, really good week for Cassie, without a doubt. And as I start to wrap this video up, I would like to go over a few little things real quick. And this is for new and returning players, so chances are if you've been playing this game for a while, you already know these details. The first thing I'd like to go over is how you actually gain access to Cassie, and that is by finding the Snitch on a weekly basis. Now, as most of you know, the Snitch can be located on multiple areas of the map. Now, what I'm showing you right now happens to be my most successful and favorite one to hit up. It's in the Federal Triangle by the 1040 safe house. And what I do is I go to this location, and if the Snitch is not there, I reset my control points. The footage you're looking at right now is from yesterday, and what I do on a weekly basis is every Tuesday morning I find the Snitch, speak with him, that way on Wednesday when Cassie becomes available first thing, I can go to her location on the map and see what she has for sale. The other thing I'd like to mention really quick is once again I want to stress the importance of really taking your time going through these vendors. Now I'm back at the clan vendor and you can see this swap chain is better than the one that's actually at the Gunrunner, so you want to make sure you compare the two before you make any purchase. Therefore, what I do on a weekly basis is I buy all of my stuff on Wednesday. That way I can see what Cassie has for sale, I can compare it to what the other vendors are selling, and that way I'm not, you know, wasting time and resources and making multiple purchases. On that note, my friends, I'm going to wrap this video up. As always, I want to take a moment and thank you all for your continued support. And please, like I always say, if you have any questions, comments, or feedback, please let me know in the section down below. I'd also like to mention really quick, for those of you that have reached out to the channel, whether you're new or just returning, and you're asking some of the best ways to level up your character in the shortest amount of time, meaning you only have, you know, an hour or so to play and you really want to maximize that gameplay, I am putting a video together showing you some of my favorite spots for tomorrow. On that note, my friends, I'm just going to let the rest of the video play out. However, like I mentioned at the beginning of this thing, if you happen to be new here, feel free to hit that subscribe button. If you enjoyed this, you could hit that like button as well. But most importantly, take care of yourselves, be kind to each other, and we will talk to you soon. Thanks again, everyone.
Wish it would cool off a little.
Good to see you. I need to call an exterminator.